Hi everyone, my name is Federico Tartarini and I'm a postdoc at the Berkeley Education Alliance for Research in Singapore. I'm also one of the main developers of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tools and I have a PhD in Engineering and Information Sciences. In today's presentation, I'm going to show you some of the thermal comfort tools that CBE has recently developed. In particular, I'm going to talk about the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool and pythermalcomfort. The former is a tool that can be used for thermal comfort calculation and online visualization of thermal comfort regions, while the latter, pythermalcomfort, is a Python package that can be used to calculate several thermal comfort indexes. The aim and objectives of this video are to show you how to get started with them and which are the main features, and then I will show you where you can find the official documentation, where you can find some video tutorials. I will also show you and talk about some practical use cases. The CBE Thermal Comfort Tool, it is a web-based tool, which means that you can access this tool from any device that has a web browser. The first version of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool was published in 2014. In 2019, we released a new version and a major update, and we include several new features. And now we made the tool compliant with the ASHRAE 55/2020. On the left side, I have the input section where I can input some environmental and personal factors. And on the right side of the tool, we have the output section where we can see all the outputs. The main tab is the ASHRAE 55 tab, which complies with the ASHRAE 55/2020. I will go over this tab a little bit more in detail later on because it's the most important tab of the tool. But let me show you which are the other tabs. So the second tab is the EN16798. This tab is structured very similarly to the previous tab. However, in this case, we are performing calculation in compliance with the European standard. Then we have the compare tab. So the compare tab uses the ASHRAE 55/2020 equations. However, in this tab, you can compare two sets of input conditions. Let me show you an example. So right now we have input 1, and let's activate also input 2. As you can see, the input 2 is the dark blue area, input 1 is the light blue area. Let me toggle the units. So now that we have toggled the unit, we want to compare two of the same conditions, so we're going to set the same condition inside here. What we want to change and we want to see is how our airspeed affects the results. So let's increase the airspeed for input 2. So now we can see the results here on the right side. As you can see from this chart here, by increasing the airspeed, we can slightly move to the right side the thermal comfort region. What does it mean? It means that if all the other conditions are equal, but only the airspeed changes, people will perceive that higher temperatures are as comfortable as lower temperature when the airspeed is lower. This is very beneficial in buildings, especially during warm days, because instead of keeping people cool by reducing the temperature set point inside the building, we can simply increase the airspeed. If you want, you can also add a third input into the chart here, and you're going to have a third region here. Then we have the Ranges tab. The Ranges tab allows you to change one input parameter. At the moment, we have by default selected the clothing level, but we can of course change that, and we can change to airspeed, clothing level, or metabolic rate. Let's choose airspeed. First, we toggle between the units, then we change the maximum airspeed up to 80, and we change the step. So now we have three areas. One, which is the comfort region for an airspeed of 80 feet per minute. Then we have one, which is for 40, and one, which is for 0 feet per minute. You can see that where the region overlap, it means that people exposed to all these conditions, so both people which are exposed to 80 feet per minute and people who have 0 feet per minute, they're both going to be comfortable. But also show us the outer region. If people have control and can select their fan speed based on their preference, we can actually see that people are going to be comfortable between 75 Fahrenheit up to 84 Fahrenheit. Then we have the upload tab. The upload tab is very useful if you want to upload a large set of inputs and if you want to calculate in bulk several comfort indexes, such as the PMV, PPD, standard effective temperature and cooling effect. If you don't know what is the meaning of each of these comfort indexes, you can always click here on this link and you will be redirected to Wikipedia, but let's see how we can use this upload tool. First, we have to download the IP unit template, and we can open it with any CSV reader. Then we have a set of inputs which are there just by default, and just to show you what you need to enter, you can of course delete some of the rows and change some of the values. So let me change this value, let me save the file on my computer, and then I go down here in file upload, I click on choose file, I select the file that I just saved on my computer here, open it, I click on upload file, and the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool automatically will calculate the results for us and will download a file. We can open the file and we can see all the results. These are all the results that the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool has generated for us. So not only calculates the PMV and the PPD and the cooling effect and the standard effective temperature, but also calculates if these conditions comply with LEED. Now that I've covered all the tabs, I will go back to the ASHRAE 55. So at any point in time, if you want to find out more about the functionalities or if something is not clear, please visit the help page or the documentation page. Also, another thing that I would like to mention is here in the footnote, you can raise issues on GitHub. You can find out more when visiting our video tutorials. You can also access the source code. And if you're using this tool, please consider citing us. And finally, if you open here in version, you can actually see the change log. Here in the change log, we keep track of all the changes and all the fixes that we have done to the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool. Let's go back to the ASHRAE 55 page. Now, I want to show you here how you can toggle between different thermal comfort methods. So right now, we just have had a look at the PMV method, but we can also plot the results on the adaptive method. I will not go into detail in this video how to explain about how the adaptive method works. On top of having the ability of changing some of the input parameter, you can also select some typical activity using this drop-down menu. And the same can be done also for the clothing. We have also an additional functionality which allows you to create a custom ensemble. So you can just click here and you can select the clothes that you want for a specific ensemble. So in this example, I've selected ankle socks, shoes, underwear, office chair, trousers, and t-shirt. So I can click here on set cloth value and the value will be automatically updated here and the chart will also be updated automatically. Alternatively, we can also calculate the clothing based on the outdoor air temperature at 6 a.m. So if you set 77 Fahrenheit, you can set the cloth value and this is the estimated cloth value. Solar gain of on occupant is an extremely useful tool, which allows you to estimate the mean radiant temperature delta if a person is exposed to direct solar radiation. I will not explain in detail how to use it in this presentation, but I will encourage you to look on YouTube and look at the video tutorial in which I explain in detail how you can use this tool. But basically, if you use this set of input parameters, you can click on calculate, this will calculate the mean radiant temperature delta, and then you can press on adjust MRT, and this automatically adjusts the operative temperature. One other useful feature that I recently added to this tool is the share button. So let me give you a practical example. You have a client and you have designed a building for a specific set of input parameters. If you want to share this condition with your client, you just have to copy this code, you can send it to your client, and then basically the client will be seeing all the same input as you. By default, the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool shows you the psychrometric chart with the operative temperature on the x-axis. However, you can change that. You can select the relative humidity versus air temperature chart, where we have the relative humidity on the y-axis and the dry bulb air temperature on the horizontal axis. You can select the airspeed versus operative temperature. This chart is quite useful if you want to understand the impact of increasing airspeed on the thermal comfort region. You can see that For this specific airspeed, 20 feet per minute, people will be comfortable with a temperature ranging between roughly 74 and 80 Fahrenheit. If you have an airspeed of 80 feet per minute, then people will be comfortable between 78 Fahrenheit and 84 Fahrenheit. Now that I've shown you the main features of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool, I would like to talk about the PyThermal Comfort Tool.
We release PyThermal Comfort because we notice that the major limitation of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool is that sometimes you want to have a faster way to calculate thermal comfort indexes. For example, if you're running a building energy simulation and you want to quickly calculate the PMV or the SCTE temperature, you don't want to key in manually in the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool all the input variables and get the output. Of course, you could use the upload tool, but still manually every time you will have to upload a CSV file into the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool and then get the results. PyThermal Comfort allows you to automate all that. You can basically import a CSV file, perform the calculation, and then save the results. I will show you an example in a second. PyThermal Comfort can be installed both on Mac, computer, or Linux system, as long as you can install Python on your computer. If you cannot install Python on your computer, you can also use a Python compiler online via your web browser, such as Google CodeLab. So the official documentation shows you how to install PyThermal Comfort. It contains a link to some examples and tutorials. If you prefer to watch videos instead of reading the official documentation, you can also visit YouTube and look for my playlist that I've uploaded about PyThermal Comfort. Finally, in the documentation, the most important page is Functions and Documentation, where you can read about each function. So let's say that we want to calculate the PMV and PPD. I can just click here, PMV, PPD. It provides a description about the function, and then it tells you all the parameters, all the input parameters that you need to specify, and then it also tells you what the function will return. So let me show you a practical example on how you can use PyThermal Comfort. So we have here on my computer a folder where I have a file called template-ip. This file is open here in Excel, here at the bottom of the screen, and you can see that is the same file that we used before. Let's see the benefit of using PyThermal Comfort. And let's assume that, for example, this is the output of Energy Plus or of any other software that we use to design a building and calculate environmental condition inside. Here I'm using CodeLab, which is a very useful tool from Google because you can run Python code directly from your web browser. You can sync it with your Google Drive folder. So we have to install PyThermal Comfort, import a few libraries, and then run this line of code. This line of code will read our file that is locally saved on our computer, but at the same time is synced with my Google Drive and is showing us the content of the file, which is the same as we have here in Excel. Then we want to calculate the PMV and PPD. This also will save the file back locally on our computer. As you can see here, there is no file called results.csv, but after I run this line of code, in a few seconds, we can see first the results here printed on our screen, but at the same time, you will see that here on the right side, the results file will come up and we can actually open it and see the results PMV and PPD. But what is the advantage of using PyThermal Comfort? Let's say that Energy Plus or any software that we use to calculate these results, then we run it again and the results will change, or there will be a new line in our file. So let's add a new line in our file. And for instance, let's change this temperature to 79 Fahrenheit. We just have to save this file locally, run again this line here. Now the new line has been read by Python. We just perform the calculation again and we get the new updated results, and the result file also will be updated locally on our computer. This, I believe, is an extremely powerful tool because instead of you having to upload manually the file in the upload tab of the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool, you can calculate all these results programmatically and automatically, and of course you can run Python locally. Throughout my presentation, I mention a lot of online resources and find more information here on this slide. If you want to find out more and if you want to connect with us, you can also send us an email. I really hope you found this presentation useful, and thank you very much for listening.